What is good, YouTube? Back here with a whole nother banger, bro. I hope y'all do enjoy the video. Comment, subscribe to the video, bro. This is the third video. This one, I'm wearing the same exact shirt, if y'all wondering, if y'all watch my videos like that. But whatever it's called, let's get into the video. I'm gonna start reacting a lot more. If I get copyrighted, I really don't care. But then I just have to make another video. Five scary things caught on camera in the woods. Leave in the comment section what you guys want me to react to, too, because I don't really know what to react to. I have to find videos and all that. Let's get into it. Let's see if it's really scary. I don't really get it. It takes me a lot to get scared now. I don't know why, but let's see what's up with this. It's a pretty long video, so if you have to stay for the whole video, let me know.
Five scary things caught on camera in the woods. Something in the forest. Scary things have been happening around the Umatilla Indian Reservation in Mission, Oregon.
Oh, you wrote to 2,000 subscribers, yeah, we can do it.
Of the night that seemed to originate from the swamp in the nearby woods. One night around 11 p.m., a man heard bizarre noises and went outside his home to try to capture some of the creepy sounds on his phone.
January 21st, about 11 p.m., I'm a couple hundred feet from my house. Anybody hear it going off in the background right now? Kind of sounds weird. Kind of sounds doggish, hyena-ish, but you can hear it going off in the background right now. It's really kind of strange, just to say the least. It's been going off for about 15, 20 minutes so far.
Oh, he might die.
By the fire station. And, it's pretty crazy, so if you can hear this.
The funny part is that he documented it. He's like, July 5th, 1999. He says, but like, no, he probably knows he's about to go in the woods and get fucked up, yo.
Listen,
let's just see.
That'd be crazy. Hold on.
First of all, where are you? You're not even supposed to be over there.
I mean, that almost sounds like laughter.
No, nigga, that's death. That's not laughter. Someone's laughing about their death.
Actually gotten closer since it started. It's probably only 200 feet, 300 feet from me right now.
I want to see something happen. I want to see.
I don't know what it is or what that is going off right there. You can hear it.
All right, we're skipping it. We're skipping this one.
Some coyotes around here.
It just nothing's happening.
A long time.
I'm trying to see if something.
I'm not sure why. If foxes and coyotes have been around here that long, why we wouldn't have heard them before? And all of a sudden, since November, things have been just going crazy around our community.
Well, Halloween.
Some locals have even claimed that the area is home to a Sasquatch.
Sasquatch, nigga, what the fuck out of here? But first of all, Halloween's a month before. Halloween's a month before November, whatever. So that could be a reason, you know. Clowns could still be wandering around and all that. That sounds like a clown.
And that this creature is the source of these whales and screeches.
Sounds like a girl screaming.
Pretty sure my friend who's doing a documentary on Bigfoot will enjoy this footage.
Where do you live? Why do you do documentaries
on Bigfoot?
Bigfoot?
Or simply an ordinary animal calling into the night? Let me know what you think down in the comments.
I think it's a girl getting killed back there.
Drive in the woods. Sometimes you don't even need to venture into the forest on foot for scary things to happen. This couple in Russia are simply driving down a street through a wooded area.
It's always the weirdest spots, Russia. What?
At night. They certainly aren't prepared for what happens.
They're both. Hey, yo, I wasn't expecting that, yo. That scared me. That scared me.
A random tree suddenly crashes to the ground right in front of them. and are forced to drive right through it. Luckily, there was no serious damage and no one was injured. But the driver seems to have almost had a heart attack when the tree came crashing down.
What's the coincidence of a tree falling down? Alright, yeah, ready? A tree falling down. I'm sorry I'm stopping the video, but a tree falling down right when you're driving. That happened to me. I'll just keep driving. I wouldn't stop. And especially on the... His freaking scream got me more scared.
Decorations. A man hiking through the woods in Suffolk County, New York, happens upon a truly bizarre setting. A bit freaked out, he pulls out his phone and begins filming. He also pulls out a large hunting knife to protect himself, just in case.
What the hell is a hunting knife gonna do?
Okay,
what is that gonna do? You need a gun if you're in the woods.
Sort of, we're like on the border, because like there's a side of the woods.
You need to extend a block, okay?
But I came to a trail, that led to a trail, up the hill, and I came down this, and as you can see, probably can see, it's blocked. There's trees knocked over, blocking it, and cut down so that it's hard to get down the hill. But I saw what looked like a fire pit. And remember, we're still in the woods. We're still in the woods, right?
Not really.
I don't know what this is. Do you see the trees? What do I... Okay. I was like, okay, these are probably no trespassing signs, or maybe it's something for the wildlife or something.
It says death.
Look what these are.
Missing person posters are taped all over the surrounding trees.
Look at that.
And a blanket and empty food containers are spread on the ground. There's a strange structure of sticks and branches. And there's a shovel propped against it.
They're probably building houses and stuff. Let the homeless people be.
The hiker hears voices approaching and makes a hasty exit.
Stacy Peterson, 23 years old, missing from Illinois, 2007. Oh, I heard voices. We have to get the out of here.
Run. You're running pretty slow. I'd have been up the hill already.
Using info from his hiking tracker, he reported the location to local police. What happened next either perfectly clears everything up, or makes it all even more mysterious, according to your point of view. Police questioned a nearby property owner and were told that the whole macabre setup was simply decoration for an upcoming Halloween party. An explanation that the law enforcement officers accepted without further investigation. However, the original poster of the video wasn't convinced. After all, the video was recorded on...
I don't know. I wouldn't believe it either. I'd be like, are you killing people?
October 3rd, well before the usual time for any Halloween party. And even so, the missing posters look like they've been hanging there for a long time, and certainly not put up recently.
Yeah.
This obviously is the top. These aren't new. Like, not just that this is 2012, Noblesville, Indiana, right here.
I mean, like, BB gun bullets in it.
What's the water damage? These bits have been hanging up for a while. Who the f is gonna decorate this? What the f? This guy's a grown up.
Either way,
how did he get taken? What?
Poster pointed out, it's still a bit perverse to use real missing posters of people's loved ones as Halloween decorations.
Yeah, that's fucked up.
Cabin in the woods.
Here we go.
An abandoned cabin in the woods is the quintessential ingredient for thousands of horror films, short stories, and just all-around scary things. So why would anyone decide to not only go to investigate a scary cabin in the woods?
If he's alone, my son got some balls though. If he's alone,
also set up their camp right outside its front door.
Oh, there's more people.
Well, this adventure-seeking group of French Canadians did just that, and the results were. Pretty much what you would expect.
Ouais. Ça fut une super de belle soirée. Qu'est-ce que vous en pensez, les amis?
Moi, je pense que le feu, c'est sympa.
It's like 3 people, 4 people. That's not enough. It's like 7.
Hey,
Find that flashlight. Fuck, stick away. Did you hear, buddy? Nah, you finna die.
Shoot him.
I'm too concentrated in this video. Let's see what happens. It's blurry for me too, if you guys are wondering. It's not blurry for it's blurry for everyone, okay? Just to make that clear.
The group spots some bizarre thing peeking out of the cabin door at them. When they go to investigate, it's gone. But then they spot the thing again, now outside the cabin.
Oh, Amasa trying to be slick. He trying to be slick with it.
They pursue again.
I gotta watch that again. Yo, he popped up out the cut.
But then they spot the thing again, now outside the cabin.
Hey, yo, he cool with it, yo. I'm gonna let him rock. Yo, he tried to be slick with it.
They pursue, but again, it disappears.
My son went behind the wall. Y'all not ready for his quickness.
So is this just a hoax by a bunch of bored camping Canucks? Or is it something supernatural?
I just think it's a random ass kid down in the woods. I don't know what to say.
Scarier than nature. Scary things in the woods don't always have to involve animals or dangerous creatures.
See if this is
sometimes there are far more frightening things lurking on a woodland path. Three boys who were dirt biking deep in the woods ran into something they never expected.
I would've.
Oh my god.
Don't take your eyes off him, he got a gun.
An apparently intoxicated man comes lurching out of the woods, screaming. A gun in one hand, and a beer in the other. He blocks their path, demanding that they stop, and then asks if they've seen a silver Subaru.
Silver Subaru, Have you seen it up there?
No.
Sure.
Yeah, I'm positive.
He claims he's been robbed.
I haven't seen him.
But for obvious reasons, the boys don't stick around to hear the full story.
That's not funny, buddy. Alright, but I hope y'all did enjoy the video. Kind of started the video. This is the last video of the day. I made 3 videos today. Some creepy people out here. Wow. Alright, we're just gonna end the video here. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Comment, subscribe to the video. I'll be talking later. Peace. I'm all done. Making videos. Hello.